want to show you famous songs you didn't know were covers and what their originals are. Let's do it. Red, red, oh yeah, Red Red Wine is a cover. I think I actually knew this. Stay close to me. Don't let me. I love this version though. Red, red wine. Huh. Neil Diamond. Stay close to me. It's way more fun in the reggae version though, let's be real. Jack and Chain, Jack and Chain. Okay, I think we talked about this one before on the channel. Oh, yeah. Oh, this is a cover? It's been so long since I heard Mr. Big. Such a fun band. Oh, yeah, yeah. Actually, Cat Stevens has written a lot of songs that had kind of better covers because his singing isn't the best, but his songwriting is... Not surprised. Oh yeah, I think the original is better here, actually. Ah, yes! Listen to that. This era of pop music, though. This is literally, I grew up with this stuff. I mean, it's terrible, but it's got something. Wait, what? Oh! I'm so surprised. George Harrison doesn't feel like a cover artist, but who knows? They did Twist and Shout and stuff. What? This is a cover? This doesn't have a feel of a cover at all. Huh. The Guess Who. Not the Who. The Guess Who. Okay. Sick voice on him, actually. Oh, yeah. Oh yeah, I've heard the original of this. I haven't got the will to try. It's a guy, right? Take myself, there's another version as well. I think I'm thinking of a totally different one. The Maria Magdalena song. This one, 1985. It's the same song. That is like the same song, right? I guess they're just very similar. Okay, so people are talking about it being plagiarism. Yeah, I mean, the first like two lines are exactly the same. Okay, anyway. No one thinks this is an original, surely. Ah! Shaka Khan, let's go! Come on. Yeah, she's got it. Never heard this song in my life. Oh, wait, no, it's this one. It's the one from all the commercials for the razors. Yeah, baby, she's got it. Well, I'm your fetus. Ah, that's so sick. There's just something about that old bad sound of those old recordings where you're just like, this sounds so sick. Just a grit of it. Smart thing would be to make music kind of like sounding like that, but about modern things, like making a song that's singing about whatever, TikTok or whatever. But sounding like that, it would be a weird mind glitch. By the way, welcome back to another daily video. My name is Joe from Rumi Official, and today's compilation is by Issy Aino. Let's keep going. Ha! Milli Vanilli. They didn't even record their own music. That's a big scandal when it came out that they didn't sing on their stuff. I actually want to know who sang on Milli Vanilli's stuff. John Davies actually sang. They did not sing on their albums or in concert. Bruh. I would have been angry at the time, but now it's just like a weird little music fact, you know what I mean? Now it's true. Ooh, ooh, ooh. I feel it in my finger. Ah. I feel it in my Christmas heart. Is all around me. I feel it in my finger. Okay. Oh, that's an old song then. I feel it in my toe. I love this guy. Look at him. Look at him go. Oh! This is a cover? Oh. That was a cool voice. Oh yeah, this is a classic. Used to sing this in kindergarten.
across the sea. Okay.
Never really knew it was Rods to begin with. This is a cover of what? Oh, sounds exactly the same. It's the same key as well. So it's pretty low key then for a girl. Because a hound dog is a cover? Of what? Those lyrics are totally different as well. It's interesting how things can be so different in a cover.
Especially back in the day.
I feel like there's more restrictions now on what's considered a cover. You might not even get to release something like what Elvis did nowadays. Didn't Elvis sing this? Okay. First released by Brenda Lee, but then Elvis's version was Pet Shop Boys inspiration. Aww, that's cute. She looks like she should be on a bowl of very fancy old-timey cereal. Maybe not a bowl, but a packaging, you know what I mean. What? Is this a cover? Didn't I choose this as like really iconic in a video the other day? This one? And it's a cover? I need to reassess my life. What? Almost identical as well. I guess UB40 does a lot of covers. Dylan did write a lot of good songs. Oh, his voice sounded good there as well. What? What? I always thought this was a Queen song. What? Huh. I'm the great. The Platters. It's funny because the Queen version almost feels like a parody, just in the way it's stylized. Yeah, this is the Monkees cover, right? Talked about them in our fake bands video. Love hurts, love scars. Okay. Love wounds, cool voice. And bars in the heart. Love hurts, huh. Love scars. Oh, that's cute. Love and just great lyrics. Ah! This is a cover? Dang, all the songs I grew up with. That looks so much like Mariah Carey, by the way. Are you gonna tell me that's not Mariah Carey? Come on. Oh, it's not Blondie's? Whose is it then? Okay. Hey, reggae. Let's go. Ah. This is such a cute song. Music video could do with some work. Okay. Spoke into his eyes, I thought you died alone. Alone. Funny to see Dave rolling this with those little bundles of sticks, drumsticks. Funny. Other words, a secret code. Oh yeah, this one I feel like everyone knows. Okay, guess this in the comments right now. Who made this originally? There was a secret code. Leonard Cohen. Apparently he wrote like 80 verses for the song and sang different ones live different times. That's a pretty cool way to make people come to your concerts to always have different verses. Ah! Doesn't surprise me. It's so such a clean version. Ooh, baby, I love you. Here's Sandra, I talked about earlier. What a coincidence. Original, way better. Come on. Oh, Unchained Melody is a cover. This is so many people's like favorite song. I think it's Simon Cowell's favorite song. He talked about that in this video. Huh. Oh, over 1,000 covers of this track has been made. That's crazy. This is a standard, right? Super old. Ah, that's it. Oh, this is a cover. This is a cool vocal take. Now I'm gonna be dumb here, but The Family, was that Prince's band or something? Yeah, it was formed by Prince. Wait, Prince wasn't actually in the band? So why was he on the picture?
I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 okay. And the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire.
I fell into the burning ring.
Oh, so the song was written by Johnny Cash's wife and released by his wife's sister first, and then he made it? Okay.
To the burning ring of fire, I fell down.
She holds that Pepsi. What? This is a cover too? Oh yeah, it's a cover of Take Five's Everybody Get Up Singing. No, okay, that's later. But... The Arrows. Covers were so common back in the day. Yeah. Well, I know this wasn't the original. Yes, the Supremes. The haircuts, love it. You want to outline like, okay, so where does the head start? Is the head like this or is the head like this? Oh, sick song. Her voice. Okay, so it's not Harry Nilsson's. Not that I knew that version. What? Ah!
If living is without you.
Without the long notes. Ah, that's always funny. When someone writes a song and it's like, and then it becomes a diva song later with just the notes super long. I do feel like I Will Always Love You was also changed in that way. I will always love you. And that becomes, and you know, it just goes on forever.
Knock, 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 all hey.
This is a cover?
Hey, hey, yeah.
I'm blown away by so many of these examples. Let me know how many you guys knew or didn't know in the comments. I should have known this, but I didn't. Freaking production style. Oh. I like this way better.
But my
dream. Oh. This is all stuff from my childhood. That is a great version, though. What was that? Run.
As my conscience seems to be.
Neil Young seems to have written a lot of stuff, just like Bob Dylan. Very widely covered songwriters. It's just fun to hear different versions of the same song, I guess. Especially when they're this different. When we do our Who Sang It Best videos, I always complain that like, oh, everything sounds the same. Everyone has the exact same track. So this is more of an interesting version of like, everyone has made the songs their own. Not everyone, but like 90 something percent of the songs in this video have been like a very different take. This is a cover? I was such a big fan of this too. He sings great on this. Okay, that sounds exactly the same. Dang. I feel fooled. Amazing vocals always on Hall & Oates. Take a piece of me. This sounds great. What a production. Kylie Minogue, she's been going on for a while. So funny. I love that type of song. So just like, hey, let's try to enforce this dance craze. Oh. I feel like a broken record, but like, I didn't know this was a cover, guys. What's happening in this picture? Oh, he's doing this on her? Okay.
My girl, don't lie to me.
When Kurt Cobain sings covers, he's looking on a paper for the lyrics, I guess.
My girl, my girl.
First known as a folk song, which dates back to at least the 1870s, one of the first recorded and most recognizable versions of the song was released by Lead Belly.
My girl, don't lie to me. Tell me, where did you sleep last night?
Around me are familiar faces.
Well, I knew this was a cover, but this is such a great version.
Worn out face.
Instant depression. All around me are familiar faces. Oh, cheers for fears. Worn out places, worn out faces. Could have it all.
My empire of dirt. I will let you down.
Oh, yeah. People talk about this cover all the time, the Johnny Cash one. It's cool to take something so modern and make it old school. Click here if you want to see a video where we look at covers that are better than the originals. And I will see you tomorrow in another daily video. Take care and stay safe.